What's up, everybody? CHM Carnivorous here. I hope you're having a wonderful day and a wonderful week. As promised, I wanted to bring you what the Stellidium DeVille looked like after about a month. The video was posted a month and a few days ago, so we'll just call it a month. And if you remember in that video how small the plant was, I'll actually cut away and show you a piece of it now. But now, this is the kind of growth you can expect in a month. So this is sort of a just where I throw cuttings and stuff. So I wasn't really too concerned with it outgrowing. I will say, though, I was not anticipating how fast it would grow. People told me it is grows faster than a weed, but you know, I was just kind of thinking maybe that was hyperbole, but definitely not. So as you can see, it's flowering profusely, which this plant does. And the carnivory occurs on those flowers. It's also got the trigger on there. So when a bug hits that, those flowers will trigger and remove their pollen and put it onto the insect. But they grow profusely from their roots. And so I'm going to show you this. The tank is starting to look a little funky here with detritus and everything. But do you see all those little streaks? Those are all roots. And these are baby plantlets that are coming from about 6 or 7 inches away from the mother plant. But those are all the little babies that are growing off from the roots. And so it's goes about here all the way over to here, and then it goes back. So that one little rosette has produced all of this. And what's even more prolific about this plant is, I don't know if you can see it here. See if I can zoom in. Little plantlets grow off of the flower stalks, and then those little individual plantlets actually grow flowers. So this plant is an absolutely insane grower. I highly recommend it if you have an ability to keep it separate. Putting it into a communal area like this is not advisable unless you're like me, don't really care if it takes over, but certainly it will outgrow everything. Now, if you're new to Stellidium, they're called the trigger plant because of these little tiny triggers on their flowers. And so when a bug lands on that, it hits this little trigger hair that springs forward and then transplants pollen onto the bug. The carnivory happens, see if I can get it to scroll even more, right at the center of your screen there on the flower stalk is some dew. It looks very much like a sundew, and that draws in insects, traps them, and then they are digested by the plant. This has been known as a pseudo carnivore because it only is carnivorous when the flowers are blooming, but the fact of the matter is it flowers near all the time. So in my mind, it is certainly a carnivorous plant. It does all the things. It attracts bugs purposely, catches them, and then breaks them down and ingests their nutrients. So by all accounts, it is carnivorous. And it is prolific, as you have seen. Now, what I'm interested to see is I purposely laid down this flower stalk because I want to see if those little aerial plants will actually grow roots, or if this is similar to Venus flytraps with their false vivivory, where it will just die off with the flower stalk. So interesting to see. I will keep you posted on that as well to see how that goes. But in all, Stellidium DeVille, I highly recommend it for any new grower, any growers really. It's just such a cool addition. Native to Australia, there's a ton of different varieties out there, but this one is going to be the most common as they are not very widely collected as of yet in personal collections. But definitely, if you are concerned about your plants intermingling, keep this one separate. And then one final note is, like I said, they grow from the roots. So if you keep it in a pot and a community tray, it will actually grow out from the bottom of the pot and will go through the water and then take over other pots. So specifically, keep this one separate, even out of community trays, if you are concerned about that. Now, I do have some concerns here. If you can see in here is a Venus flytrap. that is starting to get taken over. So I'm going to have to remove that Venus flytrap. And then there's a couple more in there that will get strangled out. So definitely something to look out for if you're growing it in a terrarium like this. All in all, hope you enjoyed this video. I'm glad to be back. Took a little break as the plants were in dormancy. I decided to take a little dormancy myself, but I've got a lot to share with you. There's been a lot of cool things happening, and just wanted to start off with this one just to show you what 1 month of growth looks like. I hope you have a wonderful day and a wonderful week. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.